colleges and universities and clubs throughout the tri-state area. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, let's give it up for Mr. Brad Ryan!
Awesome to be here in Marietta. Not only is this my first time in Marietta, but it's obviously my first time at the Lafayette. How about this place?
Yeah.
This place is the bomb, man. This rocks. Nobody here really agrees. One lady. Anyway, it is awesome to be here. I came down from Pittsburgh and I almost did not make it because on the drive here, I actually hit a deer with my car. Yeah. However, the deer I hit was an animated Christmas figurine in a fenced-in front yard. I hit the deer, but I missed the DUI checkpoint, thank you very much. Hoping for the same luck on the drive home. But anyway, then, I get all that cleaned up, start to drive. What happens next? I'm in a fender bender. Guy in the other car, turns out he's a proctologist. He rear-ended me. And he gives me the finger. I was hoping for two, but I was too tense. That would have never worked. But I got down here thanks to my GPS. I have a talking GPS. Does anybody have one of them? Has that technology made it into Ohio? I got a talking GPS. She talks to me in this lovely, sexy voice. She's like, turn left on Markneysburg Road. Turn right on Front Street. And the whole time I was thinking to myself, what are you wearing? By chance touching yourself, because I am. And everything's going great. I'm where I need to be, I'm on time, I'm not getting lost. And all of a sudden, GPS decided to go PMS. She's like, turn right on Front Street. You just checked out the brunette in the black skirt. You think I'm fat? Take me back to my spot. When I do long drives like I did today, we came in from Morgantown today. I like to listen to those medical call-in talk shows on the radio. Are you familiar with them? And I heard this interesting fact today on one of these shows. I heard that for a man, masturbation is the number one preventative tool for avoiding prostate cancer. Now, based on that fact, I can safely surmise that should I die 1,000 deaths, prostate cancer won't be one of them. I got some carpal tunnel going on, but that's treatable. I take a different approach to hitchhikers than probably most of you do. See, typically when I pick up a hitchhiker, I make them do the driving. I actually get in the back seat. It makes me feel important for a little while. And there's that awkward point where it's like, you can pull over now and get out. This is where I go north. Anyway, I don't know about Ohio, but in Pennsylvania, it's illegal to text while driving. And I'm not above confessing to you people that I sometimes, you know, violate that. I text while I drive sometimes. And I have to confess, I did that today on a drive here, but I don't know what's worse. The fact that I texted while driving, or the fact that I texted somebody a picture of my junk while I was driving. Shit, I took that picture at a long red light. But one thing I can tell you is my grandmother was pissed when she got that text. But she reciprocated. We're becoming sissies in this country. Does everybody agree? We're becoming wusses. I mean, you look on the menus now. Now, what do you have? Gluten-free. Gluten-free this. Gluten-free that. Seriously? Our grandparents and great-parents' grandparents didn't have gluten-free. Why don't you just call it testicle-free? Because they're like, hey, dude, grill a set and eat it. It's a cookie. Just a cookie. Anyway, anybody here on a date? This big date night for anybody here in Marietta?
Yeah.
You can applaud, you can answer. You guys are on a date? I was on a date the other day. This girl talked about her dogs all night. She's like, I have a yellow lab, I have a black lab, I have a chocolate lab. She says, what do you have? I got a freaking meth lab, man. It's a lucrative business. Stop by. I got a gas mask that might fit you. I actually do have a dog. Where my dog lovers make some noise. Okay. People like dogs more than dating in Marietta. Took my dog to the vet the other day. They told me over the telephone to bring along a stool sample. So I did. However, when I got there, I was so embarrassed because they meant from the dog. Have you been feeding your dog corn? I actually stopped pouring water into my dog's water dish. Anymore, I just pour in carpet cleaner, because that way when he pisses on the rug, it makes for an easy cleanup. I try that one at home, it works. So this is where I start to get into my part of the set about relationships, because I'm a relationship guy. And when I'm in a relationship, I like to be the one with the upper hand. I like to be the one in charge, the decision maker. But because I tend to choose to be in a relationship with a woman, none of that shit ever happens. Because like relationships, there's things you need to incorporate into a relationship to make it work. There's ingredients to successful relationships. And one successful ingredient in my current relationship is we've learned give and take, you know? But what that means for us is if she gives me a blowjob and I can take a nap, things are going well. It's give and take, right? You're shaking your head, but it is. You need to try that. Relationships. I'm divorced. Anybody here divorced?
Put your hand up.
Yeah. It's not like a badge of dishonor. You'd be proud. You learn. You learn from a mistake. I'm divorced. We were married. Two incomes, we were living large, driving around in a shiny white BMW convertible. But we took that to the next obnoxious level because we got that personalized license plate with our initials on the back. Everybody's seen that, right? You know what I'm talking about. It's like people in front of you, ooh, BMRTOR, look, we're married, woo! Well, guess what? Now we're divorced, and guess who has a shiny white BMW convertible? Yes, she does. She's got herself a new personalized license plate that reads H-A-H-A-H-A. And that very fun and eventful drive I made from Pittsburgh, guess what? That was done in a 2002 Ford Festival. With my own personalized plate that reads F-K-N-C-N-T. God, I'm not bitter. Prior to the breakup, we tried to spice things up. Who here is married? You guys are married. We tried the whole blindfold bondage thing. Are you familiar with that? Oh. Bullshit, I can pick you out in a crowd. So you know the routine. Like, first she blindfolds me, then she tied my wrist to the bedpost. Well, for suspense, she tiptoed out of the room. When she came back, she started doing the most amazing thing to me with her tongue. Or so I thought. That's when I heard her running and yell, Buster, get off the bed! Bad dog. She's gone and I got Buster. He's a good dog. He likes peanut butter. The married couple in the back, you're in the dark, nobody can see you. Does she have a pet name for your thingy? Honey, see me after the show. I was in the bathroom behind him. I got some ideas. But I asked my ex-wife one time, I said, honey, how come you don't have a pet name for my penis? She said, you want a pet name for your penis? I said, yes. She said, okay, how about I call it acupuncture? And I was like, why acupuncture? She said, because it's just a teeny tiny little prick and it's not really effective. And when I stopped crying, I told her, I said, you know what? You're vajayjay. It reminds me of one of the most beautiful places on earth. The Grand Canyon. Yeah, because it's a very large hole that tends to be quite dry and uncomfortable. It's way too many visitors there. When one time my ex-wife, she was on hold. She was on hold with a travel agent. She was booking airfare for an upcoming vacation. And while she was on hold, she says in a sexy voice, she says, "I really want to join the Mile High Club." So I got excited until I realized she booked me on a separate flight. That joke just doesn't get what I usually expect from it. It's just not that good. So after she left, you know, we lived together for like 11 years, and when she left, it's just me in the house. And with it just being me in the house, it took me forever to get enough dishes to run the dishwasher, and I hate running it half full. But then I discovered that my socks and underwear come clean in the top rack. So, you know, we're running the dishwasher half full. But anyway, I'm single again. I do some online dating. Anybody here do that? I got a call bullshit because I emailed like 16 of you. I've been blocked by 8 of you. I'm going to start an online dating site for people over 70. Yeah, I'm going to call it expiration date. I tried online dating. I was emailing some girl back and forth on the internet. We finally made arrangements to meet. However, when I got there, she did not show up. Instead, some guy named Chris Hansen from Dateline NBC was there. He's like, "Sir, can I ask you what you're doing here?" I'm like, "Chris, what are you doing here, you perv?" Help yourself to the sweet tea. I said, "Joe, lighten up. I'm just kidding. I actually like my women a little bit older. In fact, yesterday I stopped by the senior citizen care facility. I had flowers, candy, a six-pack of chocolate and sugar. I was ready to party." I'm single again. I go out bar hopping. Single guys, you know how that goes. You start out with $100 in your pocket, unless you're like a stand-up comic, and you start out with $37, $38. You go from bar to bar to bar. You wake up the next morning with $4 or $5. You wonder where it all went. I did that last weekend. Started out with $37.50. At about the third bar, I made the mistake of stumbling into a gay bar. I woke up with $400. I had a really sore throat. I like women. I really do. I like women, ladies. Guys, shout out your favorite part of your lady. You're not involved, are you? Hey, one guy yelled bank account when she punched him. Personality. Boobs! We like boobs! We like your boobs. Ladies, your breasts come in what? Cup sizes. And I'm here to tell you that, ladies, your cup sizes are like grades in high school. Because A's and B's get you into college, while C's and D's put you on a stage like this around a brass ball. I was at one of them places last night because I had an extra $400 to spend. And the girl dancing in front of me, the girl shaking her stuff, it turns out they weren't real. They were enhanced. They were fake. So I used that as a reason to justify giving her counterfeit money all night. You fool me, I'm going to fool you. Here's my water. I paid for my lap dance with Kohl's cash. New TV show. It's not that new. Anybody see Naked and Afraid? I saw there's a TV show called Naked and Afraid, and I thought, my God, somebody filmed a documentary about my sex life. Guys, that's Naked and Afraid. I like you people. You're fun. You're a little bit like stuffy, but you're fun. I feel I can open up to you, right? I can share a dark personal secret. I'm very confused by my recent obsession with amputee pornography. Quite frankly, I'm stumped. We got guys in the room, guys my age. I'm 49, I'm getting older. I now know I'm officially old because I changed the batteries to my TV remote control less frequently than I do the batteries of my nose hair trimmer. But guys, you're up there at my age, you know, sometimes we need a little help down there. There's that, everybody's seen that commercial for Viagra where it says, ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex. So I go to the doctor, I said, doc, is my heart healthy enough for sex? And he said, no. I said, put me on a fucking transplant list. Immediately. There's a new soft drink coming out just for gay men. It's going to be called Brokeback Mountain Dew. What do you call a constipated white rap star? M&M-a. A new store opened up in my neighborhood. It features knickknacks for the home, household items, and hot R&B singers with big booties. It's called Bed Bath & Beyonce. Okay, back to the dirty stuff. I was talking about dating. I'm not above sharing with all of you. You know what? Dating was slow. I tried phone sex. No, it was late, drinking, dating wasn't working out, I was bored up, flipping through the adult classifieds of a local publication, and I settled in on this picture of a beautiful tight ass. It's a 1-900-GET-SOME. I picked up the phone and I dialed. And on the other end, answered this angelic voice. It said, hello, I'm Judith. I'm hot, I'm wet, and I'm waiting to feel you inside of me. And I responded, Mom? Mom, is that you? Bradley, is that you? What are you doing calling these numbers? I rate you better. I'm like, Mom, seriously, does Dad know about this? She says, yes, honey, your father knows. How do you think we put you through college? I'm like, Mom, this is horrible. This is the worst day of my life. I just want to curl up and die. And she's, honey, my beautiful baby boy, relax. Take a few deep breaths, honey. We can talk about this. Would you like to talk about this? I said, yes, Mom, I would. She said, first, I'm going to need your credit card number. So we talked. 20 minutes, $60 later, I felt a little better about things. Anybody go on vacation this year? I went to Arizona. I was visiting the Grand Canyon. I'm on this shuttle bus touring the south rim of the Grand Canyon. And there's a sign on the bus that said, no pets allowed on shuttle, except seeing eye dogs. Now this is where I need everybody to follow me, because the Grand Canyon, and that, the real Grand Canyon, not my ex-wife. The Grand Canyon is one of the most visually astounding spectacles in North America. How many blind people do you think are making the pilgrimage here to take that? Seriously, dude, get off the bus, walk to the edge of the canyon, tap the canyon, be like, wow, that is something, huh? Take a picture, tag me on Facebook. Facebook, we just had Christmas. Christmas is whose birthday?
My cousin Steve's.
Jesus. Is this going to offend anybody? Oh, screw it. I'm going to have the microphone. It's Jesus' birthday. What do you think Jesus would think of social networking if he were here on the earth with us? Would he be on Facebook and Twitter? Like, what would a Jesus tweet go like? It'd be like, in New Jersey for a hockey game, go Devils. At lunch with friends, all you can eat fishes and loaves. Come on down, there's enough for everybody. I swear to God. Jesus is listening to Stairway to Heaven on iHeartRadio. How about Facebook updates from J-Man? Jesus is now friends with Peter, Paul, Judas, and Iscariot, and 8 other people. In a relationship with Mary Magdalene, but it's complicated. Or lost my ass on Monday Night Football. Those Saints screwed me again. This is fun. It's cold down here, man. It's cooler here than it is in Pittsburgh. You get a lot of snow down here? This question is for all the guys. Guys, please play along and be honest with me. By a round of applause, who at one point in their life has ever tried to write their name in the snow? It's that time where I'm envious of guys named Al and guys named Ed, right? You don't need a big full bladder to do that. poor kid named Sebastian's pretty much screwed. Just like fades off. But because it's easy for us guys, it's easy. We just like unleash it and like aim. You girls, you want to write your name in the snow. It's a little bit different. What's your name?
Fallon.
Fallon, what's your name?
Liv.
Liv. Liz. Liz, you want to write your name in the snow. You got to get down and dirty with it. You're like... And you know you're hardcore if you dot the I by dropping a deuce. I like you guys. We should all go get high. Where are my pot smokers? Make some noise. Really? More people? Wow. Meet up with you guys after the show. So people like to take a toke on the bong. Well, there's a new product coming out just for you. It's going to be called the Baraku Bonga. Couple hits off of this pipe, your head will fill with dreams that will not be realized. You'll see change that won't occur, and you'll make promises you'll be unable to keep. Smoke that. Relax, it's a pot joke, not a political joke. Wow, I'm so tight, man. I actually don't smoke pot, I'm a drinker. Drinkers out there? Woo! I think I've developed a drinking problem. You know how I know that? I've been through so many field sobriety tests. They are no longer challenging. Seriously. I can actually recite the alphabet better backwards than I can forwards. I don't give a fuck with the cops. I'll be like, really, Ossifer? Backwards? 1 second, Ossifer. Z. Y. X. W. V. U. T S R Q P L N M L K J I H G F E D C B A. Now I pass this DUI. Please don't pepper spray my eye. Driving in today, I stopped for lunch because this place had advertised outside on a big sign that said, "Try our special Angus burger." However, the wind had blown the letter G off of the word Angus on the ground. I wonder why it tastes like shit. Don't get that one with cheese. So with my anus burger, for those of you who couldn't play along, I had a big bowl of wedding soup. And because that's an option on our menus, but you know what's not an option? Divorce soup. Do you know why? Because every time I'd order up a big bowl, my ex-wife would get 70% of it. And it would leave a really bad taste in my mouth. I like honey barbecue wings, and I had some honey barbecue wings the other night, and I learned two lessons the hard way from eating honey barbecue wings, because they're sweet, they're tangy, but they're really sticky. First lesson I learned, don't decide to scratch one's unshaven junk after eating honey barbecue wings. The other lesson I learned is, don't decide to eat one more wing after scratching one's unshaven junk. Very good.